In this video, we're going to learn how to find the dimensions that will minimize the amount of material used in the construction of a soda can. Okay? Now, a soda can, as you should know, will be cylindrical. So we're talking about a closed soda can, obviously. So it's going to be, we're going to need the surface area. And why the surface area? Because this is what is... this is what should be minimized, right? The surface area is the amount used in the construction of the soda can, right? So let's write this. Oops, sorry about that. Let's write the surface area formula. So once again, since it's cylindrical, well, let me perhaps draw it to make it easier for you to see. Right, so the soda can will be cylindrical in shape. So you're talking about the top face and the bottom face, they are circles, right? So we will have pi r squared plus pi r squared, right, summing up their areas, and also the curved surface area, right, the one that also has the height involved. Okay, so that means multiplying the height with the circumference, and the circumference will be the same at any point, right? So it's going to be plus 2 pi r multiplied by the h, the height. Okay, that's the surface area, curved surface area. Okay, so now to simplify, it's going to be simply 2 pi r squared plus 2 pi r h. Okay, so we will need to take the derivative using this equation, but before we do that, we need to make sure that the derivative, when we take the derivative, we will only have one variable on the right side. But as you see now, there's the radius, one variable, and the height, the second variable. So there's nothing we can really do here, right? Because we're not dealing with implicit differentiation. This is an optimization problem. So we need to express this total surface area in one in terms of one variable, right? So for this reason, we're going to use the provided information in the beginning that the soda can will have a volume of 12 fluid ounces, right? So we're going to say the volume is 12 fluid ounces. But realize that in order to understand the units associated with the construction of the material, we have to have the proper units conversion, right? Because right now we have fluid ounces, but we're not going to build with fluid ounces, right? That's not the units we're going to use. We're going to build, let's say, in cubic feet. Okay. Sorry, we're gonna build in feet, right? So we need to. This is volume, which means that we will have to deal with cubic feet. So we're going to convert to cubic feet. Okay. So we're going to have multiplied by. And you should know this, it's going to be 1.80 469 cubic inches per one fluid ounce. Okay, so that's the conversion factor there. So fluid ounces get canceled out. So you're left with 21.656 28 cubic inches. Okay, that's the volume. Now we're ready to use the volume formula for this soda can, right? Because we know that the volume formula is going to be pi r squared h. Since we already solved for the b, we can just substitute this in, and we're going to have 21.65628 is equal to pi r squared h. And now we can solve for h in terms of r, and then that h value in terms of r will be plugged in into the surface area, so that we're going to deal with, well, let's actually solve for the r squared in terms of h, so that we're going to deal with h's only when we're dealing with surface area. Okay, so r squared becomes simply 21.65628 divided by pi h. Okay? So now we can plug this formula in the surface area formula. So we're going to have surface area is equal to 2 pi, and then the r squared is going to be this here, right? 21.65 628 divided by pi h plus 2 pi rh, right? So it's going to be plus 2 pi. Now, what is the r? If we take the square root, the r will be simply the square root of this, right? So it's going to be the square root of this, 21.65628, divided by the pi h, okay? And multiply it, of course, by the h there, right? Because it's part of the formula, 2 pi rh. Okay, so now it actually simplifies, right? Because these pi's are gone. So it's going to be, with the calculator, it should give you 43.31256 divided by the h. Now plus 9.30, again using the calculator, 726, 1681. And now realize that pi divided by the square root of pi is going to be simply square root of pi. Okay, we're going to multiply that. And also h divided by the square root of h is going to be simply square root of h. Okay. So now we're going to take the derivative. Okay, so the derivative of the surface area as a function of h. Realize that now we're only having the surface area being expressed as a function of one variable, and that's the height, and that's what we needed, right? So now taking the derivative, as you know, 43.31256 is a constant, so we take it out, and we're dealing with pretty much 1 over h, and the derivative of 1 over h is negative 1 over h squared, right? So basically, the first term becomes negative 43.31256 over h squared. And then again, using the chain rule, using the power rule, actually, the power rule is sufficient here. H is to the power 1/2, so 1/2 is multiplying these constants here, so 9.30726 1681 is divided by 2, and we get as a result 4.65. Okay, 4.65363084 radical pi divided by, and the h, the radical h goes on the bottom, right? Because the power becomes negative 1/2. So that's why radical h is in the denominator now. So now, in order to find the minimum value, the height which makes the surface area minimum, we have to set this derivative to zero, right? Because the derivative means the slope, and where the slope is zero means where the function starts to increase from left to right. Okay, so now we're going to set this to zero. We're going to copy everything down. 312 divided by h squared plus 4.65 363084 radical pi divided by the radical h. Now we can multiply both sides by h squared, and I'm going to just keep writing there. So we're going to have 0 is equal to negative 43.31256 plus, now h squared divided by the radical h is going to be basically using the properties of exponents, h to the power of 4/2 minus 1/2. Okay, so that's h to the power of 3/2. That's the resultant power for the h. Right, so it's going to be plus 4.65 363084 times radical pi times the h raised to the power of 3 over 2, as we just discussed, right? 3/2. And again, we got that by multiplying h squared to all three of these terms, right? So when h squared multiplies this second term in the sum, h squared divided by radical h gives you h to the power of 3 over 2. Okay, so now solving for h is basically going to be h to the power of 32 is equal to 43.31256 divided by 4.653633084 times radical pi. Okay. And now to solve for h, you're going to basically take this quotient to the power of 2 over 3, right? Because to make this h from 3 over 2 the power to 1, you basically multiply this h raised to the power of 3 over 2. You just take it to the power of 2 over 3, right? Because 2 over 3, when you take the power of a power, 2 over 3 makes sure that 3 over 2 multiplies the 2 over 3, and you get 1, right? So h is to the power of 1 as a result, right? So I'm just going to copy this down, and we're going to raise it to the power of 2 over 3, 4.65. I know it's a lot of numbers, but I'm not going to round anything just yet. So I'm just going to take it to the power of 2 over 3. So h is equal to, let's see what we get, 43.31256 divided by 4.653633084 times radical pi taken to the power of 2 over 3. That gives us 3.021. Okay, 3.021096925 inches, right? Because we're in inches. And the dimensions, so we have to find the radius, and the radius was the square root of 25.65628 divided by the pi h, right? So we're going to take that 21.65628 divided by pi multiplied by the h we just found, 0.2109695. I'm going to take the square root, and that gives us 1.51 0.5484463 inches. And I just want you to note something. So these are the dimensions. I want you to note something, that when you take the first derivative, you will notice that if you take the height less than 2, you should get the negative first derivative. And that simply means that the function is decreasing to the left of the height, to the values less than 3.02. If you take the height values greater than 3.02, take 4, for example, and plug it in to the derivative equation here as a function of h, you will see that the derivative will be positive, and that the first derivative will be positive. Okay, and it will just say that that the function is increasing. Okay? But in any case, this should prove that this is indeed the minimum value that you're looking for. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video.